Back to reality.
I love that show.
It's very hip to be on the show.
Best show since no other show.
Happy Tuesday.
I love you guys. You are hilarious.
It's Tuesday.
It's only Tuesday.
I absolutely love you. You're thoroughly entertaining.
I'm very excited. It's Tuesday.
Another Tuesday.
Come on. It's showtime.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to NSS. This is the Reynolds Report. Comic Simon Brodkin ran on stage during Kanye's set at Glastonbury on the weekend. Brodkin says he did it for Taylor Swift. He ran onto the stage during a performance of the song Black Skinhead. The comedian was quickly escorted away while West waited to continue his performance. On Twitter, the comedian said he dedicated the stunt to Swift, who was interrupted by West during an acceptance speech at the 2009 Video Music Awards. The interruption apparently didn't faze West, who ended his 90-minute performance declaring, with characteristic understatement, that he is the greatest living rock star on the planet. Well, if we have to call Bruce Jenner a woman, Rachel Dolezal black, and Donald Trump a presidential candidate, why the hell not? Piñatas bearing the likeness of Donald Trump have begun popping up in Mexico, a response to controversial comments Trump made about Mexican immigrants. During his presidential campaign announcement, Trump said, "When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. They're sending people that have lots of problems, and they're bringing those problems with them. They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists. And some, I assume, are good people." Whoa. Meanwhile, NBC is distancing itself from Trump after his racist remarks. The network scolded Trump and said in a statement, "Donald Trump's opinions do not represent those of NBC, and we do not agree with his positions on a number of issues, including his recent comments on immigration. We will reevaluate Trump's role as host of Celebrity Apprentice should it become necessary, as we are committed to the franchise." And then, the Supreme Court rules in favor of gay marriage and Obamacare. The only way this week gets any worse for Donald Trump is if there's a ban on hairspray. The world's ugliest dog was crowned over the weekend. It's so unattractive that it hasn't been able to get married no matter what the Supreme Court says. Disneyland has banned selfie sticks. Now, if they could just ban male top buns and Google Glass, they could go back to being the happiest place on Earth. Jimmy Fallon is recovering from a hand injury after he fell and nearly tore his finger off during the taping of The Tonight Show on Friday evening. It's the worst Tonight Show injury since Leno stabbed Conan in the back. A new study shows that ordinary house cats are far more prolific killers than anyone thought. They may look like innocent domesticated suburbanites, but they're basically the Sopranos with whiskers. In Rome, a cab driver charged his overweight customer an additional fee after a tire blew. The customer then filed a complaint. He says the cabbie humiliated him, fat-shamed him, and used an insulting term by calling him an American. And a British woman was saved by her 38 JJ breasts after she was hit by a Mini Cooper. Obviously, the car was totaled. Thanks, everybody. We have a new episode of The Reynolds Report for you every weekday. Be sure to check out The Being Frank Show, starring Frank D'Angelo, live Tuesdays and Thursdays at 3 p.m. Eastern, right here on NSS.